coming up next.
Tudor, across Australia, it's Young Talent Time.
Of Young Talent Time for you tonight. And here's your kids, Tina, Michael, Karen, Joey, Katie, Vincent, Danielle, the Talent Team!
Whenever I'm out to making dreams come true, I see.
sound team, everybody. Looking at just great. Hey! Just wonderful. Okay, don't give them too much. Don't give them too... They'll get big heads. How you doing?
Good!
That's terrific. I've had a problem all week. Michael and Joey, come here. I've got to sort this out. We've had a problem all week. This is true. They didn't know I was going to do this. Remember last week's opening with the special thing that... The special cabaret or carnival show that we had last week, right? It was a great fun show.
Yeah.
And right at the end of it, we had Joey's face stuck in a hole.
Right.
And Michael, unbeknownst to Joey, suggested, why don't you put a pie in his face, you see? And so all during the week, he's been ribbing him about the pie in the face, you see? And so Joey said to me, what's the chances of getting even? So, Michael, I'm very sorry about...
Weekdays, switch on to TV One's Happy Half Hour.
Isn't that fab?
I think that's definitely something we should get into.
On Mondays, Wednesdays and Fridays, get your dose of fun in the sun with TV One's teen queen, Gidget.
Who, me?
You got it.
Then on Tuesdays and Thursdays, bop till you drop with your favourite songbirds, the Partridge Family.
Sounds good.
You can say that again.
So let's go through it one more time.
I've got it.
You gotta be kidding.
On 3:30 Mondays, Wednesdays and Fridays, catch Gidget. Then at 3:30 Tuesdays and Thursdays, groove with the Partridge Family.
What do you think about that?
I think it's a good idea.
Don't I know it?
It'll be fun. Let's do it.
Right on.
It's the Happy Half Hour. 3:30 weekdays on TV One.
Oh, what a beautiful baby. I thought we had the youngest member on Young Talent Time last week, didn't we, Katie? A 19-month-old. How old's this one? 3 months. Isn't that incredible? And just lying back there in all the innocence, doesn't know anything about nuclear war or anything like that, just like, what a beautiful world. What an incredible baby. I feel a lot better now. I've had all that cream out of my nose and my ears and everywhere else. Unfortunately, we have two less members in the Young Talent team now. Only gagging. These are beautiful things, aren't they? What are they? Why am I holding this, standing here stupid, holding a doll? Go on.
Danielle's going to sing My Boy Lollipop with the boys.
And what are these?
They're little dolls.
What are they called?
Lollipop dolls.
Lollipop dolls.
Hmm.
Aren't they cute? Aren't they good? Let's give one to the little baby. It's bigger than the baby, isn't it? Okay, here's Danielle and my boy Lollipop, and with a couple of the boys, too. So give her a clap.
I'm the one desire.
song. We'll squeeze it a bit.
That's beautiful too. I love it. That's for all the little kids watching Young Talent Time, and especially that beautiful little baby, three months old.
Yes.
And you've got your lollipop tie on?
Yes, I'm all prepared tonight.
And you're looking lollipop too. Okay. Do you know that's the first time I've ever had a pie in my face in 20 years of being in show business?
Is it really? Lucky?
It's You've been initiated now.
It's a very unusual experience, I'm here to tell you. Contestant number one, competing for some great prizes here on Young Talent Time, is a young fellow that we had on the program a couple of years ago. He's grown up now and he's looking very good too. He's representing Victoria, ATV 010 in Victoria this week. Dean Stidworthy is his name, and he's got a beautiful song. It's called the song from Arthur's
theme. It's one of my favourite songs.
A beautiful one. So give him a big warm welcome. Representing Victoria, Dean Stidworthy.
All of his life, his master's toys, and deep in his heart, he's just a boy. He's living his life one day at a time. He's showing himself one really good time. He's laughing about the way they want to be.
It's one of my favourite movies too. Dean, I was a little bit hot and cold about your performance tonight. It's the only way I can really explain it. You've got a very positive approach and a very pleasant vibrato and singing style, but sort of on the other hand, you just seem a little bit controlled, a little bit cool in some areas, and I think you need to balance that out a little bit. I guess the operative word is to warm it up a little bit and make it a little bit more believable. Tonight, I don't know, I've given you 83. Yeah.
It is, my friend, the old deserted house. They say at night, strange sounds come from this house. Come, let's go closer.
Here's the story of the spooks and monsters who lived in Mockingbird Lane. All of them were cookie freaks living all together, the youngest one in veins. Night when Lily met Herman, they knew it was much more than a hunch that this sick excuse for a family soon became the Freaky Bunch. The monsters where every day is Halloween, weekdays on TV1.
Oh, so hot. What's the matter with him, Dr. Waldo?
Yes, it's a very clear case, John. He's as pale as a canary. He's talked himself hoarse. He's got a frog in the throat. and he's as tired as a dog.
Do you think I should see a doctor?
Believe me, with those symptoms, you should see a vet. I recommend Quack Waldo's Karmic Cures.
This is the medicine I have here? Okay, terrific. Let's see how we go.
For all ailments, hold your nose, Vince.
It looks lethal.
Yes. Whoa! Ooh. Drink it up, Vince.
Dr. Love! Where are you, Dr. Love?
Dr. Love!
Live television, that's what it is, and it's coming to you around Australia on Young Talent Time. And we've got a cute contestant coming up next, but I just got to show you something. You know, the show that you see on television at home is only part of the show, because a lot of the show happens in commercial breaks and in between, and the audience are always kept entertained in a beaut way by Uncle Bruce Mansfield, who's our in-studio host. And Bruce, I mean, I hate to do this to you, but there's 3 million. There's 3 million. There's 3 million Australians out there, and I hate to say this, but you look ridiculous.
John, I've never been so insulted in all my life.
Are you training for the Olympics?
Yeah, I'm going in for the pole vault over in Los Angeles. You know, we'll bring it home. We'll bring home the gold.
Fine, right. Okay, yeah. Thank you. Bruce, there's a contestant here.
Yep.
Dionne Ware, who's from New South Wales. She's 11 years old.
Right.
Don't you feel stupid standing
here? I feel an
Alec
at the moment. I really do. I feel a very little man.
So...
It wasn't as funny as that, I didn't think. Dionne Ware from New South Wales. She's aged 11. She's a contemporary dancer, and she's doing the Gollywog's catwalk. Here she is.
Dione, I thought your characterisation was excellent and it all seemed to come very, very easily to you. It was a very relaxed performance. Your body control was terrific. You obviously worked very hard at your classes to be so supple. And I believe you do 12 hours practice a day, which does show in your dancing. You have a good personality, cute smile coming through to the camera. Perhaps next time you could do something a little bit more modern to show us what you can really do. But Ronnie and I have given you 86 points.
I recommend a strict diet. Yes?
Ahoy there! TV One wants you!
I think you got something.
We're looking for men to be the pride of the fleet.
As a matter of fact, we love it.
Who'll travel to foreign lands.
Any hope.
Learn to smile in the face of danger. If you think you fit the bill,
it's a cinch.
Then give up your land-loving ways.
There's no telling where this could lead.
Because TV One is now recruiting.
Come on, quick.
Sign on now for your all-time favorite episodes.
Why is it always me?
Repel's Navy! Weekdays at noon on TV One.
As you may have gathered, the What Do You Know segment this week is about snow. And did you know, and this is quiz time, just a very quick quiz. There are, of two countries in the world, Australia and Switzerland, which country has the most snow area? What would you strike?
Australia.
Switzerland? Well, I mean, most people would think it was Switzerland, wouldn't you? But it isn't. Actually, Australia has more snow area, not actually skiing. Area, but it's more snow area than Switzerland.
That's good. You're a friend of information.
Aren't I? Yeah. I'd like you to meet somebody who knows more about snow than I do. This is Philip Black, everybody. Yeah. Bring... Yeah. Good to have you with us. Phil is a ski instructor, and you're dressed up. That is fantastically warm by the looks of things.
Yeah, very warm.
Tell us a little bit about the skis that you brought in. There's different types of skis for different occasions. What's
That's
this
right,
one?
Johnny. These skis are... for downhill skiing or for alpine skiing.
Mm-hmm.
The skis that we've got over here, these long skinny ones, are for Nordic or cross-country skiing, sort of like bushwalking on snow.
Right. And what's the big one over here?
This is a mono ski. It's just a single ski. And it's sort of like surfing on snow.
Terrific. Gee, do you still use the stocks?
Do you use the stocks just as well?
What's that stuff that the Eskimos use on their feet?
Their snow shoes.
Snow shoes.
And what skiers?
And do you know what the stuff is that the Eskimos use to stick their igloos together?
They use snow. They build them out of snow.
No, they use igloo.
Oh.
Is that right? Thank you. No, it's all right. It's all right, it didn't deserve that much, really. Michael is the only one of the young talent team that skis regularly. Where do you ski, Michael?
In the city.
In the city? How do you ski in the city?
Well, actually, Johnny, in a few ski shops in the city, we've got what are called revolving ski decks, and it's a machine that you can learn to ski on.
Ah, look, there's Michael now.
That's right, here's Michael. He's at a ski shop in Melbourne called Ski Style, and they've got one of these machines, and here he is learning how to ski. He's doing just a basic snow plow now. Just learning all the basics before he actually goes up to the mountains. Right, now here he is learning to do a few easy turns. It's very, very easy and it's very, very quick to learn on these machines. Fantastic. And so when he goes up to the mountain, he'll be just right.
Fantastic. Skiing always... I mean, I've been to the snow, but to see those people roaring down the hill looks a bit dangerous. Haven't you got something a little bit safer for someone like me?
Well, actually, tonight I brought along these special pair for you, Johnny. I think they're just about your size. You can handle those.
Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. Actually, I've seen some incredible loops and turns and spectacular stuff in snow skiing.
Right, that's called freestyle skiing. That's probably the most spectacular form of skiing. Where we do flips and ballet and very fast and exhilarating mogul skiing.
Fantastic. We've got some footage of that, and we've got a song to go with it, and you'll love this, because there's lots of very beautiful snow songs, like Winter Wonderland and I Saw Mummy Kissing Santa Claus, and this is my very favourite snow song. It's called There's No Business Like Snow Business. And I thought I'd create the atmosphere a bit with this stuff. Hey!
Recently celebrated her 90th birthday and wanted the Young Talent team to wish her a very happy birthday and to surprise her with a very special song.
So happy.
Yay!
So happy birthday, Mrs. Pritchard, from all of us at Young Talent Time. And now we have Karen and Tina to sing for you, Fernando.
There's no regrets. If I had to do the same.
celebrity song. You would have been too young to have remembered that when it was on the hit parade, but that was for Mrs. Pritchard, one of our favourite viewers and who's 90 years old. Bless your heart, Mrs. Pritchard. And I get lots of cute things people send to me, you know, and I really appreciate it. People go to a lot of trouble. A little girl called Joanne Lord sent me this, and it's a complete little book story that she made up herself. It's called Holidays Again, and she wrote the story, Well, Shall I Go for the Holidays, complete with pictures. Isn't that lovely? Just gorgeous. A lot of trouble. We get some nice viewers. Lovely. Thank you, Joanne. I appreciate that. And also in the audience tonight, Mrs. Pratt is celebrating her 25th wedding anniversary, and she's with us tonight. Where are you, Mrs. Pratt? What a thrill. Isn't that beautiful? 25 years of wedded bliss. Just lovely. Bless your heart. Okay, now we've got a little bit of fun with some special guests, and I know you're going to enjoy them, because one of them appeared on Young Talent Time as a contestant a couple of years ago and now has a very professional act with his dad. They're known as the Mardex, and they're just great. Would you welcome them? The Mardex.
Witch!
We're, of course, always very grateful to Malaysian Airlines Systems and to Yamaha and to Cambrook, a wonderful Australian company who provide us with $12,000 for our educational scholarship, entertainment educational scholarship, for all the finalists who appear in the grand final. They share it between them, which is terrific. And contestant number three, two young ladies who are going to play on the organ, and this is an interesting piece. The piece is in French, and it's Toot Toot Pour Ma Cherie, which I know the last part because it means for my love. I know that much in French, but the toot toot I don't know about. Maybe it means a little car for my darling or something like that. Anyway, it's a cute song, and they're two cute kids, Ada and Eileen Askell, representing Victoria tonight, and Toot Toot Pour Ma Cherie. Here she comes.
Lovely performance, girls. You worked to each other very well, and you really look like you're enjoying yourselves, and the presentation was great. I would like to have heard a few more sort of dramatic changes in the passages, just to lift that, you know, that melody a little bit and those chord progressions just a bit out of where they were. But tonight, Honor and I have given you 85 points.
Yeah. Yes. Which means, Ronnie, that contestant number two, Dione Ware, wins today.
Oh, fantastic. I'd just quickly like to ask the audience something. Do you like rock and roll?
Yeah!
Do you like rock and roll? Come
yeah!
on! They say that old rock and rollers never die, and here's the guy who's going to rock your socks. Here's Johnny Young! Yeah!
All done up so nice. I see you wearing your dresses.
let's have a good time. I want to ask you twice. And everybody's gonna shake, rattle and roll in the morning. Shake, rattle and roll in the evening. Shake, rattle and roll, everybody. Shake, rattle and roll. Well, you can't do nothing to save your dog. O'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. When the clock strikes one, join me, hon. I have some fun when the clock strikes one.
We're gonna rock around.
And now we're going to have some fun, because you're going to get a chance to sing along with me. When I say yeah, I want you at home to say yeah too. And you here too, okay? Here we go. Everybody say yeah.
Favorite gang in Happy Days. Drop in for classics like Rock Around the Clock, but Be Home By Two. I lost my cool in the garage. He's got a big nose, but he's my brother. And I am a little red robin. That's right, grease that hair, zip up the leather, and rev up the rod, cause the whole band is back together. Richie, Ralph, Potsy, and the Pods.
Correct the window.
Happy Days on the home of television's greatest hits, TV One.
It's clean. It's just got the... Oh. I'll sing a pretty song. You like it? Oh, that's beautiful. This is little Katie. And Katie is only 3 months old. Thanks for bringing her in to see us, please. She's been good the whole show. Hasn't cried a bit. And just when she got close to me, she started to howl. It's Katie. Her name's Katie. Named after you. We've had a lovely time tonight. We hope you have too. And our little friend Katie's going to sing us all the way home. I hope you'll join us next week for another hour of fun. Good night, everybody. I'll pretend that I'm kissing those lips I'm missing. Good night, beautiful.
Good night, everybody.
Young Talent Time, advancing Australian talent. Widows Fly, Malaysian Airlines, system to Europe. And in Melbourne, contestants stay at the Rathdown International Motel.